Dr. Martin Luther King once said, "One day we will learn that the heart can never be totally right if the head is totally wrong. Only through the bringing together of head and heart, intelligence and goodness, shall man rise to a fulfillment of his true nature." Everyone at Campbell works together to bring together the head and the heart. And so today, the entire staff of Campbell Collegiate is here to rejoice with the graduates and their families and friends.
Keep not for long. funny how it feels so much. I cannot say a word. We are screaming inside. Oh, we can't be heard. I will remember you. Will you remember me? Don't let your life pass.
about it. Get this show on the road, shall we? Get this thing moving. Okay, to start tonight's program, I'd like to welcome the hippest, the coolest principal to ever walk the halls of Campbell Collegiate. Not only has she looked after our interests as students, she has become a good friend to our graduating class, and she is everything a principal should be and more.
Remember, it's now time to take on your adult share of the responsibility. You get the hint? I don't necessarily mean financially. I mean, there was a groan. I mean by what you do with your time to contribute to those you love and to your family. Take a look around you and remember that the love and dedication of family is what makes these celebrations so special. Within our families, we learn the compassionate values essential to make us good citizens of the world. And I hope each and every one of you will strive to be part of not just a house, but a home. It takes hard work and dedication to make a home. Just ask your parents. But it's worth it because home is where our hearts find peace and where our dreams take wing. It's where we can find roots and stability while outside the world is in a state of flux. Graduates, this day belongs to your loved ones as much as it does to you. And so let's take a moment now. And kids, it's time to give those around you a big hug and a thank you for what they've done. Come on, hug them. There you go.
Right now, who likes cell phones? Yeah? Who likes Motorola cell phones? Who has lost their Motorola cell phone? I tell you what, if you think you've lost this phone, I'm gonna have it with me here all night. You call it. And it's yours. Oh, wait, we already have an order? Oh, you better be yours, Gary. All right. Okay, moving right along. Our next speakers tonight are members of the SAC who have continued to keep up the excellent work of the Student Council over the past years. I know that John has continued his work involving the PHA and has started an inter-school meal program. And I know that Lindsay can always be seen around the school promoting student activities. Her name is really synonymous with school spirit. So tonight, without any further ado, I introduce you to John Gordon, our SAC president of this year, and Lindsay Durand, a member of the SAC, who will share some of the events of this past year's activities.
Really, it's all about Mr. Van Sice and Mr. Bolt. These guys could just stand up.
What?
So lift it up, where are you? There we go.
All right, so first, Mr. Van Sice. This guy, amazing work ethic. I remember back when the SAC took a trip to Russell, Manitoba, Mr. Bolt, all he wanted to do was play golf, but Mr. Van Sice was up every morning at 6 a.m. making sure we were all fed and ready for the day.
He's really like a surrogate mother to me. Giving me love when I need it. I love you.
Okay, so Thanks, Mr. Vansice. We really appreciate all your support around the school. Unfortunately for the SAC and the rest of the students at Campbell, Mr. Bolt has been promoted to vice principal at Scott Collegiate.
Which is amazing for him, of course, but I mean, next year Campbell's at a big loss. He's gone, Mr. Helliwell, a couple other teachers, they're all leaving, and I mean, I'm graduating, I won't be here. Of course, Mr. Bolt's leaving, so yeah, there's going to be a really big void in our proverbial Campbell heart.
Congratulations, Mr. Bolt. You will be missed. Good luck in your future endeavors.
What a dynamic duo. Oh my, I haven't laughed that hard in a long time. Thanks, John and Lindsay, for the memories of this past year and your crazy comedic stylings. Anyways, moving things right along here.
Teachers, parents, guests, and fellow graduates, I've come before you tonight to say goodbye to a teacher who has a career which spans 35 illustrious years. 30 of those have been at Campbell. Mrs. Markell has taught a wide range of classes over the years, including life skills, English, and almost any class relating to business education, such as accounting, typing, and information processing. She's also been a part of many extracurricular activities. Mrs. Markell has taught thousands of students, including two of my older siblings, and has seen many changes that time has brought. I myself have also had the privilege of having Mrs. Markell as a teacher. She's been my accounting teacher for 3 consecutive years, and having her class has taught me valuable lessons that I will carry with me for the rest of my educational career. Her close attention to detail has taught me the importance of organization, and her assignments have taught me the value of time management. The graduates she taught this year will always remember her for the wealth of knowledge she always presented in class. Mrs. Markell has been an important part of Campbell's business education department and will be surely missed. Mrs. Markell, on behalf of the graduating class of 2000, I bid you farewell and wish you luck and happiness in your retirement.
Thank you very much, Ryan. Congratulations, graduates. Congratulations, parents. As I was doing a wind-up in a class several years ago, one of the boys in the back said, "Aw, Mrs. Markell, you're not going to go all mushy on us now, are you?" Tonight, I do feel a little mushy. I will miss the students, the staff, and the parents of Campbell Collegiate for their support, their enthusiasm, their dedication, and their antics. No longer will I have students threaten to buy me stilts so I can reach the TV. No longer will I have a teacher, your director of education, by the way, look over at a student and say, "Lift Mrs. Markell up so she can see over all these students to the stage way up there." No longer will I be going home and saying, "Guess what they did today?"
And now a farewell to one of Campbell's most popular, funny, and best teachers to ever walk the halls of our school. I invite two of my favorite girls, Samantha Burnett and Jocelyn Mang, up to the podium to say farewell to Mr. Chris Helliwell.
Say good things about such a good person. He has always been a very special man to many of his students, in addition to being a good teacher and a friend.
Mr. Helliwell has been teaching for the past 34 years. He started his teaching career in England, and when he immigrated in 1969, he moved around from Esterhazy, Center Collegiate, and eventually ended up at Campbell, where he has taught for 23 years.
He has learned that teaching and learning can both be fun. He demonstrates this with his Trivial Pursuit games, his videos, and wacky bets he makes with his students. And most important, he demonstrated that for students to respect you, you must respect them in return.
Although Mr. Helliwell has a full-time teaching career, he has many other hobbies, such as winemaking, playing bridge, fishing, hunting, and traveling. Now that he's retiring, he's thinking about taking up a second career as a model, since he did such an excellent job in this year's Campbell Fashion Show Extravaganza.
If you were to ask any of Mr. Halliwell's past or present students about him, they would describe him as being easygoing, spontaneous, entertaining, and most of all, a brilliant man. But one thing you don't want to do is get caught not paying attention during his class. If this happens, your notes will no longer be in the same condition. And I know those of you who've had them know what I'm talking about.
There are so many stories about Mr. Halliwell. He's told us lots of things about himself, like his six-year addiction to a certain fast food product. And although we had chicken tonight, I'm sure Mr. Halliwell was disappointed that it wasn't Kentucky Fried Chicken.
But we weren't the only ones to learn valuable lessons. Mr. Halliwell learned firsthand that it's not such a good idea to catch scissors with his leg.
It's not only the crazy antics that made us enjoy his teaching. We learned a lot in his class, and his teaching went far beyond biology. And those who weren't in his class always envied those who were.
Mr. Halliwell, you've been a great influence on all of us. We wish you the best of luck in the future, and we feel honored to have been in your class.
We'd now like to call you up to receive the gift on behalf of everyone at Campbell.
That I'd just like to say that the profession of teaching will suffer a great loss at the retirement of the man who knows absolutely everything. Let's give him another hand.
You know, folks, it's true what they say. You can always tell a Campbell grad, but you can't tell them much. Thank you, Jocelyn. Thank you, Samantha, for those very kind words and those completely false anecdotes. And don't those two look pretty tonight? In fact, all of you girls look so magnificent. The guys look so handsome. They've even plucked up the courage to leave their hats at home. But you know, these grads don't fool me for 1 minute. Today is the best day of their lives, but us teachers have seen them at some of their worst. Oh yes, I've seen them, period one. On a Monday morning, the guy's looking puzzled, wondering where the weekend went. The girl's looking like they've driven the ring road with their right hand and put their makeup on with their left one. Oh yes, many is the time I felt like saying to them, why don't we just put our desks in a big circle and I'll put the lights out. Then we could all join hands and try and contact the living. But tonight I'm seeing you at the best of times, and that's how I want to remember you all. You and I, it is true, have shared some interesting times together. And if you've learned anything from me, anything at all, then I feel good about that. But as a teacher, albeit a now retired one, I feel good about the things I've learned from you. You've taught me to see the other side of an opinion. You've reminded me of the joys and heartbreaks of growing up as a teenager. And you've shown me that it's okay to be different. Tonight, you've made your friends and families very proud of you. And you've made your teachers proud of you. And I hope one day you'll make your country proud of you. And thank you again, Jocelyn and Sam. Bless you all. May the Campbell Force be with you. And before I get too mushy, goodbye and good luck, grads, for the new millennium, and the future is yours. Goodbye.
are you feeling?
Happy, sad, nervous, and excited.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm feeling you, buddy.
We'll just get this show on the road.
Okay. Well, John and I have been giving the have been given the honor to give you, the graduating ladies of 2000, the toast from all the graduating gents from the year 2000.
Problem is, we could go on about you ladies all night long. There's so many thanks to give, laughs to share, and compliments to hand out.
You can say that all right. That would take the whole ceremony.
Yeah, oh, I still remember it. The first day of high school. So many women. Yes. Oh, yes.
Would that ever suck going to an all-boys school?
Oh, yes. Amen. All of us boys have all you girls to thank for our good attendance throughout the past 4 or 5 years.
Yeah. From Heather Chimichuk to Hetty Zhang.
And all the girls in between.
Ow! No, but girls, you guys have been there for us. From a shoulder to lean on to hugs in the hallway, you guys have been there.
Let's not forget the influence you had on our personality and style. If it weren't for your fashion and behavioral whips to guide us through high school, we'd be lost.
Hey, let's not forget what they gave to our school. Without their angelic voices in the choir, the choir would mean nothing. And they gave so much wow to the drama program.
And let's talk about sports. Now I heard, don't quote me on this.
Oh, don't do this, John.
But I heard the girls did better overall and won more titles than the guy just did.
No. Guys, we know you tried. Seriously, ladies, we'd like to sincerely thank you. You guys have made attending Campbell such a steamier place.
Steamier? Wouldn't you say better?
Oh yes, better.
Yeah, and growing up with you girls from little grade 8s up to grade 12s has been such a great experience for all of us.
Yeah, I wouldn't have been the same without you ladies.
The boys would also like to wish all the girls the very best of luck in the future.
We can't wait to see you guys at the reunion.
Now would all the graduating gentlemen please stand up right now.
Right now. Graduating gentlemen. Okay, well, this is the toast to all the graduating ladies of the class of 2000.
Repeat after us.
To the girls.
And clink glasses if there's anybody near you.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, ladies.
Not only MC, but community juice man. Anyways, that was very classy, guys. Thanks a lot. Whew. Okay. Anyways, let us not hold the show any further. Next is the toast to us, the boys, to our plights and our buffoonery. So, without any further ado, I'd like to invite Cashin Nowicki, who will give the toast to the graduating boys.
Greetings, boys, or should I say men? Sometimes I just don't know. Anyways, congratulations, you've made it. All those times in English class when you're supposed to be concentrating on Shakespeare and his great impact on the English language, blah, blah, blah. You're often what us girls would call a guy's excuse for an imagination. Dreaming of the car you just can't afford but wish you could. The girl you only have the guts to talk to in your dreams. And how loud your brake torque will be leaving the parking lot after school. Okay, so maybe dreaming of such trivial things is what helped you get through all those endless hours of classes you never thought you'd pass. Well, one of your most important dreams has finally come true, and that is why you're sitting in this room today. Didn't think you'd make it, did ya? You now have a high school education, and that is something no one can take away from you, like the $5,000 stereo that got stolen from your car last week. Welcome, parents, teachers, honor guests, and graduates. I hope you all have a wonderful time as we salute to the young, not to mention distinguishing men. The last 4 years has created memories for us all. As the men of our school, you've shown your various abilities in many ways, whether being on the football team, proving that Campbell has one of the best teams Regina has ever seen, as well as on the basketball court. Back to football for a minute. It's not very often you see guys in spandex, is it? Anyways, But you haven't shown your abilities only in sports. You've also shown them in academics, computers, the arts. One way or the other, you've represented the school very well.
Graduation day always is focused on the graduate. You know what? People are always wanting to take pictures of you and make sure everything's all right. However, without you, our parents, it would not be the same. It's time, Mom and Dad, to turn the camera around. You gave up many things when we came along. Having children meant having new responsibilities and losing some of the freedom you had enjoyed. And although challenging at times, you don't regret it at all. You have been through all the transitions we have made in our lives. On the first day of school, you saw us off with tears in your eyes, hoping that we would be okay. The days of watching us dress up in our mother's high-heeled shoes and costume jewelry, boys, we know you did that too. Or our father's dress shoes, tie, and jacket. Those days were all over, for some of us anyway, I mean. You watched us grow throughout elementary school, talked about how quickly we were growing up, and felt an aching when you realized that we didn't want to hold your hand anymore. Moving from elementary to high school brought new experiences and many emotional trials. Our relationship with you began to change. We began to exert the independence you had always wanted to see in us, and yet regretted that we wanted so much more freedom. And through it all, you have been there for us. You have taught us, not just by telling us right from wrong, but by telling us stories and giving us the benefit of your experience. You have encouraged us, told us to be good and do our best, and you picked us up when we stumbled. You have taught us to set limits on certain things, and yet to never have limits or obstacles get in the way of our dreams. You have shown us patience, undying support, and the unconditional love which have helped form the memories of laughter and tears over the past 18 years. And now we make yet another change. We move from high school to the unknown, to a post-secondary institution or the workforce. And whether we stay here or we move away, things will be different. Again, you have to let go, just as you did that first day of kindergarten and the first day of high school. But we have to move on. All parents have to let their children go at some time in their lives, although there are some that are more reluctant than others. But no matter how far we travel or what we do, we will never forget you. Thank you for all you have given us. Graduates, I would now ask you to stand and join me in a toast to our parents.
To our distinguished guests, our teachers that are here tonight, to those that are retiring, to our ship's captain, who's now Fleet Vice Admiral, Mrs. Ronnie Spitalnik, fellow parents, and most important of all, our wonderfully esteemed Campbell Collegiate Class of 2000. I'm deeply honored to have been chosen to respond to our graduates' collective words, appreciation, and, just as collectively, thank you on behalf of all the proud parents here today. How could we be other than proud? Today, officially, you may consider yourselves launched. The red button has been pushed, and you are now catapulting headfirst into the realm of personal responsibility and accountability. As time accumulates and this era fades into memory, you will undoubtedly realize that it was far too short a period in your life, wishing it had been longer. Now comes the time you will set sail on the sea of destiny as the captain of your own vessel. Your destiny, or destination, the islands of success, good health, good fortune, and love. As the captain, you are responsible for your ship's safety, welfare, and most importantly, its ultimate destination. On your journey, you will visit many ports of call and meet many other captains attempting to reach the same destination as you. You will accumulate a crew of people who will share your dreams and your love, a crew that will be depending on you to deliver them safely to this very place and time you are today. Shortly after these celebrations, you will begin to realize that what you celebrated is not freedom you have finally attained, rather a loss of it. You are not breaking the shackles of accountability, but attaining them. What you gain today is the awesome task of becoming totally and unequivocally responsible for your own actions. As parents, our love and prayers will always be with you as you sail your ship into destiny, as will our advice. Advice attained by sailing our own ship over the same sea a generation before you. If you are like most young people, you have reached the point where parental advice is the last thing you want to hear. After all, as your parents, we grew up in a different world. We didn't face the same problems young people face today. Times have changed. Some of that is undoubtedly true. Nevertheless, some things don't change. It was God's idea that wisdom... Hello there. I didn't see the hook. Nope. Well, I'll just continue on. Can everybody hear me?
Yeah.
Okay. No? What do you mean no? Turn it up. Turn it up. As your parents, we grew up... I think I've been there. Yeah. Hello. It broke. Okay. It was God's idea that wisdom gained. Boy, this thing goes on. Be ready for it. By one generation, be passed down to the next. Each generation faces new opportunities and new challenges. But wisdom and truth, gained over the centuries, remains relevant. I was well into my 30s before I found out that my dad was a very smart and wise man. If you're smart, you'll take seriously the advice you receive from your parents. You may not even understand it at the time, or may think it doesn't apply to you. My advice? Listen to it anyway and remember it. There will come a time when you face an unexpected situation, and you'll be able to draw on the wisdom that a parent, a grandparent, or a teacher shared with you. You'll realize that their words were for such a time as then or now. Finally, I caution you that life is extremely unpredictable and is full of surprises. We can never be absolutely sure what awaits us over the horizon, yet God says we can be secure. He says the key to our security is our integrity. Integrity means having no flaws, being blameless, having no hypocrisy, being honest in every aspect of life, and being genuine all the time. Integrity is doing the right thing even when no one is watching. Your integrity is revealed when you respond spontaneously to something without having to plan your actions in advance. Integrity is when the way you live lines up with what you say you believe. A person who lives a life of integrity will be secure. Living with integrity means you have nothing of which to be ashamed. A good reputation is a priceless treasure. A good name may eventually lead to riches, but riches don't necessarily lead to a good name. You can't buy a good reputation. You can't even inherit one from your parents, though you can damage their good name. You earn a good reputation by living your life well over time. A good time does not derive from fame, wealth, or power. A good reputation is about integrity. Who you are, not what you've got. You're right, you are right now in the process of establishing your reputation, even as you further your education or go about building a career. You're also making a name for yourself. People will be watching you, listening to you, and making up their minds about what kind of a person you are. Once you have gained a reputation, it's hard to change it. You are wonderful young people. I have come to know many of you over the last 5 years and can honestly say I never met a Campbell student I didn't like. You are achievers, winners, a valuable asset to our world. We, your parents, love you very, very much, and we are never very far away should you need us. To quote an old Jewish proverb, "My child, observe the commandment of your father, and do not forsake the teaching of your mother. Bind them continually on your heart. Tie them around your neck. When you walk about, they will guide you. When you sleep, they will watch over you. And when you awake, they will talk to you. Go get them, class of 2000. The world is yours for the taking. And thank you for this opportunity.
You know, it's been said that up to a point, our lives are shaped by our environment, heredity, movements and changes in the world about us. Then there comes a time when it lies within our grasp to shape the clay of our life into the sort of thing we wish it to be. Only the weak will blame their parents, the times, the lack of good fortune, or the quirks of fate. However, everyone has it within their power to say, "This I am today, that I will be tomorrow." Make the best of your time, please. Do what your heart desires. What I see before me tonight is the future, and it truly is a bright one indeed. To the beach, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock, y'all. Non-stop, y'all. To the beach, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock, y'all. Non-stop, y'all. To the beach, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock, y'all. Non-stop, y'all. To the beach, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock, y'all. Non-stop, y'all. To the beach, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock, y'all. Non-stop, y'all. To the beach, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock, y'all. Non-stop, y'all. To the beach, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock, y'all. Non-stop, y'all. To the beach, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock, y'all. Non-stop, y'all. To the beach, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock, y'all. Non-stop, y'all. To the beach, y'all. The body rock, y'all. The legs rock, y'all.
Yeah.